I'm not going to make some super in-depth video about this topic, but I don't really recall people really making videos about old Roblox zombie games from over 10 years ago. Some may say that these games are a goldmine of nostalgia, but I think most people would just think that you're weird if you try bringing them up. Am I a loser? So, Roblox is pretty old, and since the platform has experienced somewhat of an exponential growth, that means that Roblox from 10 years ago has an almost niche fandom at this point. Not only were the player numbers small, but the culture back then was completely different. A lot of zombie and horror games were able to make it to the front page. There were a lot of games from genres that were either phased out, forgotten, or evolved and twisted themselves into a new amalgamation. And I believe that a prime example of this would be the Roblox zombie genre. Specifically, the Roblox zombie games from 10 years ago. That's like three layers of niche. This video is going to get like 5 views. Roblox has long been a part of my childhood, so naturally I can't really escape these memories. It's like Silent Hill keeps calling for me to come back. And like any other kid in the early 2010s, I was interested in zombies. They were just hard to avoid, alright? You had Call of Duty Zombies, The Walking Dead, and Left 4 Dead. Those were the big three that everybody was talking about, at least on Roblox. And you can still see traces of these games today. Ready to Die and Michael Zombies are what I'm referencing in particular. Reason to Die was basically just the Roblox version of Left 4 Dead. It was what I played back then because my parents let me play Roblox, but I didn't have an Xbox 360. I had no idea what Left 4 Dead was, so when I played the game for the first time, I was just simply hooked. Roblox games who take real-world ideas and port them into Roblox tend to go over rather well. It's a really timeless strategy, you see. If something did something and it worked, then just do it again. It's honestly a perfect idea. But yeah, at a birthday party, my older cousin asked me what zombie games I liked, and I replied with, Reason to Die, because I was a loser. And he replied with, Don't you mean Left 4 Dead? And then I was like, oh my god, I get it. There was also this other rather popular game based off of Left 4 Dead. It's called Contamination, and it's made by the same guy who made Blood and Iron. I've already talked about it in like 2 or 3 videos though, so I don't want to bore you to death here. There were other zombie games that came out around this time, obviously, but they weren't really translatable to Roblox. Like imagine if somebody tried to replicate Resident Evil 6 in Roblox. It wouldn't go over well. The child trying to program the game would have a stroke. Being a Resident Evil fan around this time was already hard enough. But on that same note, I will add, in 2010, somebody actually did make a proper Resident Evil game in Roblox called Roblox Evil 5. It had cutscenes, levels, a story. It was really cool, honestly. These Roblox zombie games have flooded my mind for over 10 years now. It's unbearable. My mind literally deleted all the instructions on how to understand chemistry in order to keep these memories in my head. There were also Star Battle Zombies, which was a creation of COD Zombies. Glad to see that people are still pulling the same shit in modern day. And ZombieCon, a zombie survival game with zombie unicorns and boss fights. It's broken, like most old games are. The plot of that game had you trying to protect Telemon, I mean Shedletsky's cake, from zombies after a zombie outbreak happens at BloxCon. BloxCon was basically the old version of RDC, or whatever they call it. So, in short, Roblox games back then were super creative and ambitious. Even if Star Battle Zombies aren't really ambitious by today's standards, and a lot of these games are dated, back in their day they were revolutionary, okay? Back then, in 2011 Roblox, everybody was banging rocks, and these guys managed to invent fire. But perhaps the game that has the most active fans today, okay, well, the game that sits dormant in people's minds the most would be Zombies Tower. I say this because there's been at least like 4 remakes at this point, with each version bringing in new players to share this collective memory that we call Silent Hill. I mean, niche Roblox zombie games. So, Zombie Tower is a pretty basic game at first glance. It's about zombies in a tower. You have to go through the tower, going through all 29 or so floors in order to reach the top, with each floor being unique in its own way. Well, for the most part, I think. You'll see what I mean later. There were so many unique zombie designs that managed to burrow their way into my head and never leave.
To me, the most memorable part of the original Zombie Tower as a kid was the atmosphere. The aesthetic of the tower, the sky and music as you approached its entrance just made you dread what lies within. The zombie designs were easily the most unique out of any Roblox zombie game of that time, and some of them genuinely terrified me as a kid.
I genuinely believe that these zombie designs alone helped people remember the game, because otherwise it's pretty bare bones. The zombie designs of Zombie Tower really did build some sort of quasi-lore around it. like Minecraft. A lot of zombies were holding weapons such as swords, or in this guy's case, a fucking ball with blades attached to it. Dare I call it a blade ball? If the zombies weren't holding weapons or anything, then they were mutated in strange ways. Like the hamburger zombie that just goes up and munches you. He's annoying because you can't headshot him. Along with the normal zombies, there were a great variety of scary bosses to fight, like the cyborg zombie, or the scorpion zombie, or the conjoined zombie. Look at his stupid fucking face.
I made models for the original Zombie Tower because I was a big fan of his games, especially the quest games. I was bored one day and decided to make some, and to my surprise, he used them in the game.
There were just so many different zombie designs. There's also the spider zombie, who would go on to be replaced by this weirdly incongruent insect creature called the smoke shifter. Like, okay, I guess we're just playing Resident Evil now. One second you're being chased by a horde of zombies, next thing you're seeing a giant fucking spider for no reason. There's also a handful of other bosses, but they're pretty straightforward in what they are. Once you get up to a certain point of the tower, like around the 15th floor or so, the game's map design just gives up completely. Like, there's a long stretch where every room looks basically the exact same, a giant square with rocks in the middle, and it goes on for so long until you hit the lava room, and then finally you make it to the top. It's really weird how nobody ever tried to change it. Anyways, once you get to the final level, you have to fight the giant zombie, which is exactly what the namesake says it is. You can kill it by shooting it in the knees to trip it, and shooting it in the eyeball, which probably would really hurt. Once you kill the zombie, you grab the sword, which is assumed to be the treasure that you were after this entire time, and you win the game. Keep in mind, there were 29 floors, and by no means of reviving or respawning in this game. Can you imagine how boring that would be? You can technically spawn in as a zombie, but we all know the fate of a player zombie in a Roblox zombie game. There was also a second final boss called the cyborg zombie, but he got removed from the game and nobody remembers him, so that's cool. Zombie Tower went through a variety of updates, as most games do, and it even had a sequel, which apparently wasn't even finished. I didn't even know Zombie Tower 2 existed until I played a remake of the original and dug deeper into the rabbit hole. You still can't respawn or revive players, it's just kind of the same deal, except with different zombies. And the zombies also insta-kill you. At least the rooms are way cooler though.
How did you find Zombie Tower 2? As in, like, what state did you find it in? Because I've heard that it wasn't complete originally.
It wasn't complete. I was searching for it because I wanted director work on it. So I was looking around. I was like, where could I find this? I was looking at many, like, profiles and whatever, trying to find some links. And I came across this one guy. It was Pizza Eater 8. I found that he had the game. I messaged him. He responded to me like a couple of days later. I was just asking if he can uncopy lock the game so I can edit it and do whatever to it, like remaster it or whatever.
The final boss is just this purple guy with swords and shit, and it's actually unclear whether or not this was the final boss.
I can't remember if it was fan-made or it was planned to be. I think it was in the files, like it should have been added. I kind of just went that extra mile and just kind of had it added to it, like, you know.
There's a lot of fog and heresy surrounding Zombie Tower 2, to the point where people are watching old videos from a decade ago of random kids playing the game in order to find out more. The last time I had to do something like that was when I made my Undead Nation video. Speaking of which, if you liked that video, please consider checking out my other videos, because I'm no longer allowed to run ads on that one. But yeah, minor details aside, Zombie Tower 2 was the same deal as the first one. Climb a tower, kill zombies, grab the sword. Why did the zombies have a north and south tower? I guess we'll never know. After these games broke, sometime in 2016 or 2017, it basically sat dormant for a while, until this guy named Draco decided to remake it, or resurrect it, kind of. It was basically the game, but beefed up to be a modern version, except you still couldn't revive people and the game took 30 fucking minutes to complete. A very flawed system, I'll say. Especially when private servers were disabled. The grind was also kind of shitty compared to the old game. Back in old Roblox, a lot of games were meant to be played in one sitting, not come back and grind every day after school type deal. So, compared to the original Zombie Tower, the game's remake looks like a 9-to-5 job. The resurrected version of Zombie Tower changed how a lot of the original zombies were used, which really helped set it apart from a normal remake. The previous horde of bosses were cut down to just 4 bosses, and the remaining ones were made into normal recurring zombies. The bosses consist of the baller guy, the self-insert, the dark angel zombie, and the giant zombie. The lighting and other bits were also redone as well. The gun system was also very reminiscent of Call of Duty Black Ops 2.
I wanted to learn how to make a game, so I took a shot at recreating a childhood favorite. I learned as I went, which is probably why it turned out so buggy. My goal was to replicate that same dark atmosphere of the original and bring back the thrill of defeating the final boss to new players and for those who wanted to revisit memories. As for the addition of the Wraith zombie boss, I don't really remember why I added it. I think I just wanted to add some new type of enemy into the game with a unique function, which is also why I made the Dark Angel boss summon ghosts periodically instead of them being a static spawn alongside him. The creative choice of the Black Ops 2-styled weapons was mostly because it was my favorite COD Zombies game, and the weapon engine and animations felt the cleanest to use. Trying to modernize the gunplay of the old zombie tower just wasn't going to work.
And what do you know about it? After the game didn't do very well, he ended up turning it into a COD Zombies clone called Resurrections, which is dedicated to reviving old Roblox experiences or whatever. It shares a very similar name to another COD Zombies clone from 2017. That bothered me.
The reason why I chose to transition the game to Resurrections, for the most part, was because after more than 2 years of strictly working on Zombie Tower, it was getting tiring, killing my motivation, and I wanted to expand. I removed the classic Zombie Tower mode because it was severely lacking in replayability and impossibly confusing and difficult for new players to navigate. It had too many issues that I didn't have the motivation to fix.
One day, the Zombie Tower mode will come back, but this game updates slowly, so for now, it exists only in memory. And videos. I made a few, just saying. And in 2023, we saw the return of Zombie Tower once again in the form of another remake, called Zombie Tower Reanimated. And I actually saw an actual server of people playing this one. However, when I joined, they were halfway through the game, and I was not about to wait 20 minutes of my life to play that shit, so I passed. And now the game is dead, so go figure. On the contrary, you have this group called The Proper People, who've made quite a bit of the Zombie Tower remakes, including Zombie Tower 2, which wasn't even a full game when it was defunct.
When I found the game, it was like way back in 2011, 2012. I was only like 9 or 10 playing on my stepmom's laptop, whatever. It was a hard game, and that's just like what captivated me.
It's cool that there's a lot of love when it comes to old Roblox games in particular, and a lot of people are willing to step up and remake and fix them, even though they aren't financially viable anymore. It really shows that old Roblox isn't just diluted nostalgic feelings, but actual good memories. These games had a legitimate impact on the players at the time, and I'm glad that I and many others were able to be exposed to such creativity at a young age. In contrast to Zombie Tower Resurrected, Resurrections, Zombie Tower Reanimated is a much closer emulation to the old Roblox style that classic Zombie Tower had. Honestly, I think that it's much more fun to play this version in favor of the original Zombie Tower because of the modern day additions. In case you didn't know, most old Roblox games do not age well. If you are a fan of the original Zombie Tower and want to introduce your friends to it, then Zombie Tower Reanimated is the game for you. It's similar enough to the old game, but builds on top of the old Roblox gameplay to make it less boring. However, it still suffers from a lot of the same problems that the original game had. There's still bomb zombies that instantly kill you, and also they start spawning on floor 3, so there's that, I guess. There's also the Vietnamese spike pit traps at the higher floors, except they don't drop you into a pit of spikes, they just drop you into the void. The addition of instant kills is only enhanced as a problem through the fact that there's no way to revive people, and the game still takes over 30 minutes to complete! You also can't buy and equip weapons as you go in this version. You can buy them in the shop, but you're not allowed to actually equip them unless you die and go back to the lobby first. Also, there's a prestige mechanic, but you have to beat the game 5 times in order to do it. I don't think that kids nowadays have the attention spans for this. All of these factors really add up to the impression that this game really is just made for old Roblox fanatics. Either people who played the game when they were young, or people who are interested in exploring old Roblox because they weren't there to experience it initially. Zombie Tower Reanimated changes just enough about the old game to make it look better than it actually was. It's like a faithful retelling of an old story for a new generation. I appreciate the game for what it is, but I wish that they could have tuned the experience a bit more. If they were going to change and modernize some aspects of it, why did they choose to leave others out? The instant kills, bomb zombies, and the falling floor are just really unfairly punishing. Instant kill stuff can work in video games, but it just doesn't work here, because the game goes on for about 30 minutes without any respawns. Most players aren't going to sit there and spectate for half an hour, so they're just going to leave the game. And since there aren't any other servers, They're just going to leave and not come back. It's horrible for player engagement. Guts and Black Powder is another zombie game that has instant kill bomb zombies, but they're easy to spot, and also the rounds don't go on for nearly as long. Also, there's respawning, so yeah, it's much better implemented in that instance. You should never punish your player for wanting to play your game. There's also another version of Zombie Tower that I forgot to mention earlier, and it's from this game called Zombie Stories. Zombie Stories is basically the modern day version of the old zombie story subgenre that was seen in old Roblox. I made a video about it a long time ago, actually. A lot of the games in Zombie Stories are tuned for a younger audience, as most games are nowadays. It's a nice little game that I can appreciate. The Zombie Tower mode is tweaked quite a bit from its source material. It's a lot shorter and only has like 3 zombie variants. Also, there's no instant kill stuff apart from the acid, and there's also a revive mechanic. You can beat the game comfortably on your first try, especially because the game forces you to play on easy mode in order to unlock the other difficulties. Since it's missing a lot of the charm from the original, as well as the fact that Zombie Stories is simply just a game tailored to a younger audience, I don't see this version of the game resonating with old players as much. However, in all honesty, it's probably the most accessible incarnation of Zombie Tower to date. It's not the most faithful, but it's respectable how it can teach a new generation of players and maybe even inquire them to explore further. And either way, I don't think anybody really cares about the artistic integrity of Zombie Tower. Then congratulations, you're a fucking loser. You're an adult who's been playing Roblox for over 10 years now. You're past the target demographic, buddy. How about you worry about getting a zombie on your tower, if you know what I mean? Wait a minute. Okay, so I don't really have anything left to say after that one. Anyways, Zombie Tower managed to rise during a period in Roblox history where both competition and standards were really low. As the world changed around it, it just wasn't able to keep up with the games of today.
How it worked, you had to wait for a game to start, you had to wait for the other players to die or whatever. You know, it was that wait time. That wait time, I don't think many kids or whatever would like to wait for that long for a game to start, to even start playing. And the game is difficult in itself. If you have to wait that long just to start a game after you die, like say you die on like floor 3, you're going to be waiting until whoever else finish the tower or die themselves. Player zombies, if they're like balanced correctly, it could be funner, but I don't think in a state like how the game is right now, you'd have to do a lot of editing to how the whole entire like formula of the tower is. What Drac wants to do is endless. It's just basically a whole different kind of setup and configuration of it to make it work in how today's Roblox games are.
The game's comebacks would continuously underperform due to repeating the same problems intertwined in the game's core formula. The 30-minute round time is already insane by today's standards, but coupled with instant kill mechanics, no respawning, and little to no access for mobile players, and also a general public disinterest in zombies compared to 10 years ago. The way that we talk about the legacy of old Roblox games often feels off. Old Roblox games are more tied to the period of games that they came out than compared to other forms of media, or specifically their normal game counterparts, like Steam games or even Minecraft. They very quickly lose the access that we take for granted nowadays in newer Roblox games or other mediums for gaming. You can't emulate old Roblox games like how you can emulate the original release of Resident Evil 4. They aren't preserved either, like Flash games. Old Roblox games exist in a very, very niche part of the internet that very few people have enough memory of, let alone development and coding experience that they're willing to exercise in order to recode the games in question. Roblox forced dozens of universal updates onto their platform over the years, from forcing filtering enabled to changing their coding language, which resulted in many old games being broken or privated as a result. Filtering enabled was an anti-exploit feature that resulted in any game not having it to be privated. And since a lot of game developers were either terminated or moved on from Roblox, nobody was there to fix their game. The Roblox search tool is also just god-awful. If you search up Zombie Tower or any old Roblox game that isn't Work at a Pizza Place or Natural Disaster Survival, you're not going to find it easily. In order to find these games, you're going to have to search them up on Google or look in the description of this YouTube video. My point is, most people aren't going to bother to do that. When I talk about how a Roblox game has aged, I'm not particularly asking, is the game broken or not? I'm sadly looking at whether or not the game abides by the homogenized, formulaic feature sets of modern Roblox games. Does the game throw you into action as quick as possible? Are the rounds short? Are there daily logins and playtime rewards? Is there an incentive to play it more often? Is there an incentive to play it for more than 8 minutes? Are the controls easy to understand? Is it mobile compatible? Is there an incentive to invite friends to play play with you. The problem with these expectations, admittedly, is that it brings up the fact that Roblox players have a lower tolerance for games nowadays, and therefore, the most popular games take as little risk as possible. Not just is there a lot of anti-media preservation at play, but Roblox was a very different platform 10 years ago. Zombies just aren't popular anymore, and therefore there isn't that secure ground to stand on. Even Ready to Die, a game that has roots from 2008, still has a good amount of problems that hinder it, and the new fans don't have nostalgia goggles that hide the flaws from them. I don't think Zombie Tower is a bad game, but there are undeniable things within its core that cannot be allowed if the game wants to have some measure of success today. I never beat the original Zombie Tower as a kid because every time I played, I was stuck sitting there in the lobby for 30 minutes and ended up leaving out of confusion. I literally have more childhood memories of the lobby than the actual game. Like, I remember the training room, the multiple versions of the lobby, the zombie statues that were put on display. The first time that I ever beat the game came from when I played Zombie Tower Resurrected, which was in 2022, 10 years after the original. It's not common for someone to not want to play an old game, but desire to play the remakes. But there needs to be some sort of initial interest there. Zombie Tower isn't talked about anymore, and with more time passing, the collective memory and passion for it fades more and more. As a lot of people seem to say about this sort of topic, I guess you can simply put, it was good for the time, you just had to be there. Soon, Zombie Tower will be something less than a footnote. Maybe some big YouTuber will make a video called Exploring the Old Zombie Games of Roblox, and it might get a few plays, I don't know. But more than likely, if you ask somebody about Zombie Tower a few years from now on, they're less likely to say, oh yeah, that game sounds familiar, but rather respond with, what the fuck are you talking about? Oh wait, no, sorry. I think what they say now is, what is bro blabbing about? I think you meant to say Skibbity Tower Defense, bozo. I think the saddest part about the fate of Zombie Tower is that if the world collectively forgot about its existence, literally nothing would change. The world would just keep on spinning, unless there's like some weird butterfly effect that I don't know about. Anyways, I'm Breadian, and I talk about niche Roblox games. If you liked this video, please consider subscribing and checking out my other videos because my channel covers niche topics and I rely on shares to get my videos out there. Thanks for watching. Bye.
And destroy everything. You can't leave.
You have destroyed your mic sensitivity.
So until then, you're mine.
Fuck. I don't know.
Get him, boys.
What, are we gonna get pecked or something?